Welcome to 2024, and this is Honest Wedding Advice with DJ ESG. I've been in the private event industry for 30 plus years. Over 3,500 events, weddings, sweet 16s, mitzvahs, you name it, I've done it. And this is the most honest, truthful, straight to the point wedding advice podcast you will find anywhere. There's no froofiness, there's no sugarcoating. I tell you how it is all the time. Take it or leave it. I'd rather give you the honest advice than give you some bullshit blowing smoke up your ass. But I'll tell you this, it's short, it's quick, it's to the point, and you will learn something. I'm DJ ESG, the EST of ECEG. Check out the podcast. You will not be disappointed.
DJ ESG, Honest Wedding Advice, Season 4. And today I'm talking about the vendors you really need immediately when you book your venue. So you just booked your venue, secured your date, either at a church or at the venue for the ceremony, and now you got to get vendors. Okay, so what vendors do you need right away? I've been telling people this for years, so this isn't going to change, and I'm going to tell you why. The two most important things are music and liquor. And if you don't have music and liquor at your wedding, that wedding is going to suck. If you have a dry wedding with music or a wet wedding with no music, I just made that up, wet wedding, it might still be doable. But a dry wedding with no music, ugh, that sucks. What kind of fun can you have there? Hey everybody, pass the OJ. Crickets. Yeah, great times, great times. So you need right away to book music, and you need to book the best DJ or the best band that you can find for your event, because that is going to set the tone for the entire evening. Once you get that, the photographer is next, probably on the same level with music, because that's the person who's going to capture all your pictures and make you look like a queen or a king and have all those memories waiting for you either a few days or a few weeks after the event that you can show all your friends on social media or email, and look at how amazing you guys were put together on your big day. And then last but not least, the dress. You need to immediately go and start putting on wedding dresses, because not only is that going to be a positive thing for you mentally as the bride, but it's going to set the tone for the entire wedding planning process, because now you're like, okay, I'm in this. I'm putting on this dress. It feels real. Oh, amazing. Look at me. I'm a star. Don't put this on Facebook. We can't show anybody. Just show our friends. Nobody show my fiance. How hard is that, by the way? To know you look really good in something, but you can't show anybody it, and you have to sit and wait, like, oh, I have to wait all this time before I can show anybody this dress. And then you finally pop out the day of, you're like, look at me, and your fiance looks at you, and like, he or she is just like, you look great in that dress. Oh my God. I want to tear that thing. Don't touch it! 6 hours! So, I'm telling you, those are the things that you really need right away. Music, photo, dress, and obviously the venue, which is the first thing you're going to book, because that's the date of your event. After that, it all comes easy. The videographer, the florist, the hair, the makeup, the DIY stuff, centerpieces, everything. Even the people you're going to invite. Save that one. You don't have to do that right away. What if all of a sudden somebody that you were going to invite turns into a douche nozzle? Don't invite that person. It's usually a weird cousin or some bridesmaid that you didn't even think you had to use, but now you got to use her, but then you didn't want to use her. She's blowing coke in the bathroom. Wait, that happened last week to me. Whole different story. Yeah, but think about it. Music, liquor, food, photo, dress. It's great advice. Take it or leave it. I'm DJ ESG. Peace, love, and God above, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Do you have the time to listen to me whine about nothing and everything all at once? I am one of those melodramatic fools, neurotic to the bone, no doubt about it. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm